I request Dr. Mahmood Ali, our co-panelist, to come on the dais and give his presentation.
Good morning to all respected dignitaries on the dais, of the dais, ladies and gentlemen. We all know that how big our education system is. We have more than 26 crore students in our school system, more than 85 lakh teachers, and about 15 lakh schools. And still, we accepted that we are towards, or you can say that we, the quality education is a dream is still to achieve. Since 2004, if I particularly talk about the ICT, under the scheme, ICT at the rate school scheme, government is providing ICT infrastructure to schools, and teachers are being trained in ICT since long back. Even after so many efforts in the field of ICT, particularly, and in general in education, still we are not observing the changes in learning outcomes. This figure is not new to you. This is already known to everyone, but there is a point here. When we talk about the challenge and we think about the quality education, we say that at the same time that we have challenges, but we have the potential of ICT, or you can say that ICT has potential to change the scenario. ICT can improve learning situations in the classroom, can improve the learning outcomes as we desired, but how and why it is not working as we are thinking that it should work. So there are some issues or some reasons behind it. If you want to list these issues or reasons, there are many, but I want to highlight two points here. One is that we could not understand the real meaning of ICT as it should be. Still, majority of the people who are working in the area of ICT understand ICT is something, use of computer or internet. But it is more than that. We will discuss what is the real meaning of ICT. The second issue which come to my mind is that integration in the real sense is still awaiting, means it is not there in the field. Though there are models, though there are theoretical explanations how to integrate ICT in school system or in teacher education, but still we are not really implementing or not translating that theory into practice. So what should be the real way, or what should be the practical way of integrating ICT? I will discuss whatever I have my, or you can say whatever I thought in that way or in that line. So I will start with this point that what is ICT? Though there are so many definitions, people are defining ICT in different ways, and we can define ICT in terms of functions, but I will not reiterate the definition here. I just want to highlight two points. One is that in the definition of ICT or in the meaning of ICT, there are two major functions or two points. One is the creation and another is communication. If any technology, any device, any software, any resource can create information and can communicate to the stakeholders, then it is ICT. And there is a relationship, interconnection between the ICT and education. That's why ICT is important in education. If you think about education, again, there are two major, for me, you may have some different opinion on this, but for me, education, when we talk about educational function or processes, the content, the creation of the content, or what you say, the constructivist approach, that means every child will construct his or her own knowledge. That is the main point in education, that content creation and then communication, how to communicate this communication to the students or learners. So both are, these two functions are common in ICT and education. That's why ICT is a, you can say, very much natural to education in terms of processes. That's why ICT should be defined in terms of these functions, like in this infographic, you can understand that ICT means, or it refers to sending, receiving, manipulating, creating, and communicating digital information. When we come to the next issue, that is integration, there are so many models as mentioned. I already mentioned that there are theoretical models and theoretical explanations of integrating ICT. So this is also very much known to you that TPEC is a model, very famous model for ICT integration in school education system. But you may disagree on this point, but I feel that it is not working due to some reasons. Maybe it is not really translated into the practical way. Though I have observed in many interactions with the teachers, as well as whenever we go for training, as an NCRT, I work in NCRT, so I understand this point because we interacted so many teachers during our training programs. I observed that teacher understand the meaning of TPEC. What is the meaning? But it is not really translated into teaching learning situations. Or you can say it is not really implemented as it should be. There are so many reasons behind it. I'm not going to into that detail, but the point is it is not really working in the field. So what should be the next point? Either it should be translated in real sense, it should be explained that how to integrate ICT in terms of way of this model, or we should think differently. So if I start with another point, that we also say that there is a 5E approach for constructivist teaching learning process, or it is not related to directly to ICT, but I can think in terms of ICT, how to infuse or integrate ICT in all 5Es. So if I can think in that way, it is also a kind of integration of ICT in teaching learning process. So for engaging activity, what I can do, how I can engage my children, my students using ICT. So I'm just giving you some examples. It's not that I will explain every point here, but I will just give you some examples of activities, or you can say technologies, which can be for these 5Es. For example, if I start with engage, it may be some kind of online video or online streaming video from YouTube or somewhere, where you can show some kind of context to the content which you have selected for teaching learning, and child can be engaged in that. Even you can also start with concept map, which may be created using digital technologies. Nowadays, there are so many software to create digital concepts, concept maps. So we can start with this type of technologies to engage the child with the content. Similarly, we can think about how to give the platform through technology to the learners to explore more on the content. So there are so many, again, ways to help or to facilitate this learning process using 5E approach through ICT. I'm not going to explain everything here. You can explore or you can go browse on the internet also. It is just an example how to think about ICT for integrate in teaching learning process when you are thinking 5E approach as a constructivist approach in learning. So all these 5Es can be through ICT. Then there is another way. This is my own thinking. It is not from anywhere. That when we think about the processes, because we can also think in terms of processes. There are so many other processes, but these are the major processes involved in teaching learning. The very first thing is, before coming to the class, teacher plan, or every person who is associated with teaching learning, plan either on the paper or in mind that what to teach, how to teach, when to teach. So can you use ICT for planning? Yes, we can use ICT for better planning. And planning may be in terms of time, in terms of content. So if I think planning in terms of time, it is calendar kind of things. And we know that most of the teachers who are teaching in the schools or even in teacher education, they are preparing their course calendar, academic calendar, like from if it is semester system, it is for 6 months. If it is annual system, they are preparing course calendar or the calendar for the whole year. So can I use some tool or some technology to digitize this process to make it more effective? Yes. Like, for example, if I give you one example here, Google Calendar is the most, you can say, easily used nowadays, as well as there are software. Like one software I remember, there is a software, Rainlender, R-A-I-N-L-E-N-D-E-R, Rainlender. There are so many others. I'm just giving you one example. So you can use this software for creating calendar. Means you can plan your teaching learning in terms of time. If you want to think about the planning in terms of content, you can also use ICT for better planning in terms of content by creating, again, concept map. Because whenever you have some concept map in your mind, you can focus on the major points in the classroom, as well as the students or the learners can be focused on those points. So you can use some software again, like there are so many software, but I'm giving you one example. There is a software FreeMind and FreePlane. You can use this software for creating concept map for planning in terms of content. Then you can also digitize your own thoughts noting process. Like, for example, maybe you are noting somewhere on the paper, and you will forget after 1 month or 1 year that I have gone to this conference and I have noted some points in the session, but where it is. So if you can use technology ICT for taking notes also, you can organize your notes and thoughts in digital way. So there are so many technologies, ICTs, which can help you in planning. When you come to school, or you can say when you really going to teach in the classroom, the first process is, in my point of view, that you have to present some content. You have some content in your mind to transact, to deliver in front of your learners. So how to present? Whether ICT can help you in presentation? Yes, there are so many software again or technologies which can help you to make your presentation better. So there are so many ways of development of resources. You can present the content in video format, audio format, in interactive, you can say, resources, and so many and so forth. Then the major important process after presentation is, if you will not interact with the students, if you will not communicate, the learning may happen, may not happen, I don't know. I'm not sure whether learning is happening if interaction is not there, if communication is not there. For me, interaction is the key of learning. So can I use ICT for communicating, for, you can say, continuous communication with the students, even after the, you can say, class of 35 minutes or 40 minutes? Can I continue my discussion with the students? Yes, it is possible through ICT. So I can think of ICT which can help me in continuation of my discussion, learning discussion. So similarly, assessment can also be done through ICT. The another way of thinking is, I'm not going to discuss because time is not there. So there is another way of thinking of ICT integration is approach. It may be supplementary approach, means you are teaching through your own way, and at the last, you are showing some video or audio, which is not really necessary for that particular content to learn, but you are just showing that to supplement, to show more, or to give some more, you can say, things to students. But if it is really needed, then again you are showing that video or audio, you are using that software, technology, just to add something, but it is really needed. So that is complementary. And same way you can think about the integration and infusion. So this is also one way of thinking to integrate ICT in teaching learning. Last is that which we are working upon. We means that NCERT is going to show to the public that there is a module on this on this way that how to integrate ICT in teaching learning process. So we should start with the content, nature of content. The teacher start with the content, that what is the nature of the content. Like for example, it may be factual, it may be conceptual, it may be procedural, it may be metacognitive element. So if content is procedural, you cannot use just image. You have to use some simulation or video or some interactive element. So as per the nature of the content, we have to think about the ICT. So that point, we have to remember that teacher should first analyze the content and then think about the ICT. Then the context is again very important. Context means the complete knowledge of the learner as well as the field, or the, you can say, the school in terms of education, if I say. So from where he or she is coming, what is the background, whether he or she is having the access to ICT or not at home, or what kind of resources the teacher is having with him or her, what kind of facilities are available in terms of ICT in schools, and there are so many others. So context is also important. As per the context, again, we have to think what ICT should be used and how to use. Then teaching learning method, that means pedagogy. For example, if I'm thinking about to make you understand what is the meaning of, or how to understand the metal and non-metal concept, I want to differentiate it. So I can demonstrate, or I can first project the objects to show to the learners, then they will differentiate, or they will do some activity. So for that purpose, I can use some software to create interactives. Like there is a software, there is a platform H5P, which can be very useful for creating such kind of environment where child can interact with the content or with the object which is developed using ICT. And then ICT itself is another important factor. It should not be that just we are using ICT, so I can select any ICT, but it should be selected on the basis of the potential of that particular resource. So at last I will say that yes, it is possible to improve learning outcomes, learning situations through ICT if really we are translating the theoretical explanations or whatever we understand in terms of theory of ICT into real teaching learning situations. It is possible. Thank you very much.